Hi, everyone. Hi, guys. My name is Janis. These are Elin and Kristen. We come from Latvia, and obviously, we are also very intuitive friendly. And our story today is about five elements of Vastana, because, as we all know, there are four fundamental elements in nature. Those would be water, fire, earth, and air. But do you know what is the fifth element? Now, we think it is the people, and for Astana, we propose a new district that actually combines all of these elements in order to answer the question of the task: what exactly is sustainable housing in Astana extreme climate conditions? Anyway, we started by separating four courtyards, lifting them, and creating four different communities. We then provide each community with an individual underground parking space. As you can see, there will be all the necessary community functions on the ground floor, a decent market space, a daycare center in the south, and some offices and commercial spaces. And as you can see, all the courtyards can be easily accessed by natural slopes or ramps, and the whole site is crossed by a continuous bicycle path. And so, as a result, we have these functionally separated communities that are still visually connected to the city of Astana. Combined in a chess kind of pattern, they create very well-ventilated courtyards. We then propose a park in the south, protecting the whole site from the strong south winds and creating also different kinds of active and passive recreation possibilities for the people. The semi-private courtyards serve as a local green zone with gardens and parks, and also providing recreation possibilities next to the water, the third element. And finally, we propose very well-insulated courtyards that provide shaded zones for the people to have shelter from the fourth element, the sun. And so we combine all of these elements in one loop, connecting them with pedestrian bridges and creating all kinds of experiences for different kinds of people. And here, for example, you can see the connection between the courtyards and how they are separated from the public space on the ground floor. And also, you can see that all the apartment blocks are arranged to provide optimal insulation. This, for example, is the study for the 21st of March.
As for architectural design, our aim was to concentrate on compact building volume. So we choose cube form over a long rectangular form. We get the same capacity but smaller surface area. Our goal was to protect the heated building volume from negative impact of strong winds and extensive sunlight. For this purpose, the heated core is surrounded by unheated, self-supporting shell of balconies that can be closed in winter with glass shutters and open during the summer. Building consists of different types of apartments, including two-story flats on top floors. As a result, we have dwellings for various groups of people and households. The floor plans are arranged so that the service zone is concentrated in the middle of the building. Also, we are creating public space for inhabitants within the building. Technical aspects of our design are strongly connected with these natural elements. Quality of air indoors is achieved by using mechanical ventilation with heat exchanger and also natural ventilation during the summer. Ground source heat pump provides the building with hot water. It is also used for heating and cooling. Photovoltaic cells provide energy for ventilation and ground source heat pump system operation. Water cycle consists of three systems for rainwater, gray water, and black water.
I guess that's all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. I'll give you the mic in a second.